Check.
Flashlight.
Check.
Water bottle.
Check.
Tiki head.
Tiki head. What?
Foam finger.
No, wait, what? Oh, I don't have a foam finger on my...
Chicken hat.
A chicken hat? Caitlin, why do you have a chicken hat?
Well, you never can be too prepared. You never know what's going to happen when you're in the woods. And I mean, I want to be equipped for everything we might face.
Equipped?
Yeah, equipped.
With a chicken hat.
Exactly. A chicken hat.
Okay, but why not just use a checklist? Because with the checklist, you have everything you need and then you don't take the things that you don't need. You know what I'm saying?
I do need all these things. Like I said, prepared for anything.
Okay, well, while you get yourself back up, why don't I tell you kids our new bottom line? The new bottom line is Jesus can defeat all giants.
Welcome to Whip It Up. I'm your host, Unique Monique. And today, parents and kids are going to compete against other parents and kids in a cooking challenge. In order to win today's prize, the golden spatula, the teams are going to have to impress my co-host, the world-renowned kid chef, Luca Dossi.
I can't wait to be impressed. Don't disappoint me. Now let's go over and meet our team.
I'm Cassandra.
I'm Paisley.
And we're the chef chicks.
Here. I'm Nermeen.
And I'm Sandra.
And we are...
The Aphrodites.
Awesome. Today, you guys are going to compete in the challenge called...
Sandwich Galore.
Parents and kids, you guys are going to have to make the best sandwich that you can. But you're going to have to get a little messy, kids. You guys are going to have to dive into the bowls and find the ingredients to make the best sandwich ever. Are you guys ready?
Yes. Yeah.
Awesome. On your marks, get set, go.
Let's check in on our teams. How are you guys doing?
Well, we have three ingredients only in our sandwich, but thank God we have bread, and we have more bread now. White bread. Okay, each side of the sandwich is different bread. Next.
How's this team going?
Oh, we're doing great. I think we almost have a full sandwich here.
It looks a little messy. Paisley, you got a little something on your head.
The teams, over here, team Chef Chicks is looking really confident.
What do you think about the Aphrodites?
They have lots of bread.
Lots of bread. They don't have too much turkey or anything in there, right?
Or the Lays.
Let's see how it turns out. They're looking pretty strong.
Yep, I agree on that.
What do you think?
Delicious.
Savory.
How about this team over here? The one who hit the bell.
Very big chance.
Take a quick bite, Luca. Come on over here, bring the golden spatula. Without having to say anything, who do you think is the winner of today's sandwich galore?
Just pass the spatula to the winner.
You win.
Oh, thank you.
We got the golden
spatula. Tune in next week for our next show of Whip It Up.
Ready? Here we go.
There's a city that calls me by name. There's a city that calls me by name. Yes, as I run this race, I am cheered by the saints. There's a city that calls me by name.
Again.
There's a city that calls me by name. There's a city that calls me by name. guess as I run this race, I am cheered by the saints. There's a city that calls me by name.
You guys ready?
Everywhere I go on this road, high and low, where I go with you. So I won't be afraid, it's my home, come on, man. Where I go with you. Where I go,
here we go!
Everywhere I go,
hey!
I go with you. Everywhere I go with you. There's a future that runs through my veins.
Right?
There's a future that runs through my veins. And there's nothing on earth that can stand in the way. Cause there's a future that runs through my veins. Same power that raised Jesus up from the grave. This same spirit I cannot
contain. Here we go!
Everywhere I go, on this road, high and low, where I go with you. So I won't be afraid, it's my home, come on, man. Where I go with you. Where I go with you.
Sing it again. Your breath.
Your breath upon these bones. Your fire in my soul. Your kingdom is my home all week long. And I don't walk alone.
Here we go.
Everywhere I go on this road, high and low, where I go with you.
So I won't be afraid. Come on.
So I won't be. Come what may, where I go with you.
Yeah.
Everywhere I go on this road, high and low, where I go with you. So I won't be afraid. It's my home. Come what may, where I go with you. Where I go with you. Yeah. Everywhere I go,
hey.
I go with you.
King Saul gave young David an important job as his armor bearer. One day, the Israelites' enemies, the Philistines, came into the land to fight. King Saul got his army ready, and they lined up on a hillside. The Philistine army stood on another hill, and a small valley separated them. The Philistines had a great warrior named Goliath. He was 9 feet 9 inches tall. He towered above the other men. Goliath shouted to the Israelites, "Send me your best man, and we'll fight one-on-one." But none of the Israelites wanted to fight Goliath. They were afraid of him. One day, Jesse told David to take food to the battlefield. David's three oldest brothers were in the Israelite army, and David gave them food to eat. Then David saw Goliath. He heard Goliath making fun of the Israelites, and he saw that everyone was too afraid to fight. Who is this man who comes against the army of the one true God? David asked. Then David turned to King Saul and said, I'll fight him. You don't stand a chance against Goliath, King Saul said. I've killed wild animals like lions and bears, David said. God will keep me safe. So King Saul let David fight Goliath. Saul offered his armor to David, but it was too heavy. Instead, David chose five smooth stones from a nearby stream and met Goliath armed only with the stones and a sling. Goliath made fun of David because he was a young boy, but David said, You come to fight with a spear and a sword, but I come to fight in the name of the Lord. God always wins his battles. David ran toward Goliath. He slung a stone, and the stone hit Goliath in the forehead. Goliath fell face down, and David killed him. The Israelites shouted in victory and chased the Philistines out of the land. The Israelites were not strong enough to fight Goliath, the mighty Philistine warrior, on their own. God gave David power to defeat Goliath. David reminds us of Jesus, who came to save us from our greatest enemies, sin and death. Jesus, the ultimate hero, saves us from our sin and gives us eternal life.
Okay, now they're all packed. Let's get going. We've got a long hike ahead of us, and I do not want to get behind schedule.
Okay, I'm coming. I just need to find my, I brought one for you too.
Thanks. Okay then, are we ready?
Ready. Did you not see the bear that just went right up to us? How are you no more scared right now?
A bear? I wasn't a bear. That was Chloe in a... I don't really know what she's wearing, but it wasn't a bear.
But I saw it. It was massive, and I looked through the binoculars, and there's a thing waving at us.
Wait. How are you looking through the binoculars?
Just like this.
Caitlin? You're wearing them backwards. No wonder you thought that Chloe looked so much bigger. When we focus on the giants in front of us, like a big test or starting a new school, we get scared and even sometimes run away, kind of like you did when you saw Chloe. You were focusing on the wrong thing. When we focus on the giants, we stumble. But when we focus on God, the giants tumble. It's just like when David fought Goliath. The rest of the Israelites were focused on the giant in front of them, but David was focused on how God can defeat all giants, even the ones we face every day.
That's a good way of looking at things. So, I probably don't need this anymore, do I?
No, not really.
Hey, guys!
Ah!
Hey, what was that for?
Oh, sorry, Chloe. Let's go get you cleaned up.
I raise a hallelujah. I raise a hallelujah louder than the unbelief. I raise
Hey, Caitlin.
How did you get here so fast, and why did you look like a bear again?
I walk normally, and I was just waving my hand saying hi. Caitlin, do you have the binoculars on backwards again?
Yeah, I keep forgetting that.
Yeah.
Much better.
You know, it just goes to show that perspective really matters, and it's always a good reminder to see things through God's perspective.
Yeah, I will never forget this lesson, and I cannot wait to see what we learn next week.
Me too. Hey, can we go on that adventure now? I want to see what kind of birds I can see through these.
Okay, let's go.